Let's take a look at the Nano editor in this video. If you are hearing it for the first time, Nano is a text editor for Unix-like operating systems that works on the command line. Or in other words, it does not have a graphical user interface. Nano comes pre-installed on many Linux distros including Ubuntu. Most often, Nano is the only text editor you will find on server environments which does not have a graphical user interface. So, Nano is often the first choice when you want to edit some server configuration files. Unlike Vi or Vim, which is the preferred command line text editor for advanced users, Nano is quite easy to use. There is not much learning curve. Right now, I am on the homepage of Nano Editor's website. Most often, you can install Nano from your package manager if it's not already installed. Otherwise, you can go to the Get Nano page, where you can find the various sources from where you can get Nano. Going to the documentation, there you can find a link to the FAQ page. Nano was initially designed to be a replacement for the Pico text editor. The time was late 1990s. Pico's licensing was not so perfect from a Linux standpoint. So in 1999, Pico was cloned to a new text editor named TIP. That is, TIP isn't Pico. And in 2000, TIP was renamed to Nano. Keeping the history aside, let's see how to use Nano. Let me open the terminal emulator program. Here I have opened KDE console, which is just a personal preference. You can use the default Ubuntu terminal. As I mentioned earlier, Nano is pre-installed in Ubuntu. So if I run the command nano --version, you can find the currently installed version, which is version 6.2. Nano is available in the apt repository, sudo apt search nano. Here it is, small friendly text editor inspired by Pico. If it's not already installed, you can do it by running the command sudo apt install nano. Currently, I am in the home directory. I already have a few sample files made for the purpose of this video, an HTML and a markdown file. If you run the nano command without any arguments, it opens a blank editor with a new buffer. At the bottom, you can find a welcome text along with the list of commonly used keyboard shortcuts. You can just type some text as usual, and it gets stored into the buffer. To save the file, press Ctrl O on your keyboard. Then it asks for a file name. There you can enter the path and the file name. Here I am going to save it to the current directory. So just name the file as hello-nano.md. That is, it's a markdown file. The file is now saved. Then press Ctrl X to exit the editor, which takes me back to the terminal. List the directory and there you can find the newly created file. So that's how you create a new file with Nano. Instead, if you want to open an existing file, run the nano command with the file name nano hello-nano.md and there it is opened. Next, I'm going to open this sample markdown file nano sample.md. First of all, let's see how you can navigate across the document. That is, how to easily move up and down, left and right. To move letter by letter, you can use the arrow keys, right or left. To move up and down, line by line, you can use the up and down arrows. However, most of the time, moving letter by letter is a waste of time. So, in order to move word by word, keep the control key pressed while using the left or right arrows. Likewise, you can press the control and down arrow to move to the next block of text. Control up arrow to move to the previous block. The page up and page down keys can also be used if your document is quite large. In case you press a shortcut that does not exist, it says unbound key or there are no anchors set. Here, I tried pressing Ctrl page down and Alt page down for which there are no shortcuts. Whenever you are confused, you can open the help document by pressing Ctrl G. There you can find the details of all the available shortcuts or key bindings. Those starting with an up arrow or the wedge symbol denotes the control key. For instance, here this means Ctrl W for search operation. And the ones denoted with the uppercase letter M is the Alt key. For instance, here MD means Alt D, which counts the number of lines, words, and characters. Likewise, there are lots of other key bindings. You can take your own time to explore them. When you are finished, press Ctrl X to exit the help document, which takes you back to the Nano editor you were working on. In order to select pieces of text from the document, you can use the Shift key in association with the navigation keys. For instance, I can press Shift down arrow to select line by line, Shift up arrow to unselect and go back, Shift plus right arrow to select forward letter by letter, and Shift left arrow to revert it. You can also press the Ctrl key in addition to the Shift key to make it word by word or block by block. Currently, I am at the beginning of the document, and suppose I want to select this piece of text starting from the word which, so first navigate to that block of text, Ctrl down arrow. Then using the Ctrl and right arrow to go to the word, then pressing Shift Ctrl right to select the words. Press another arrow key to unselect. There is an alternate way to make a selection without using the Shift key, which involves setting a mark at the beginning of the selection, then navigating to the end. To set a mark, press Alt A. Here the mark is set at the beginning of the second paragraph. Then move downward to select all the text you want. Now two paragraphs are selected. Suppose I want to select the whole text below. For that, I can press Ctrl End. Now all the lines are selected starting from the second paragraph. Now if I press Ctrl Home from here, it deselected the previously selected text while selecting the first paragraph. That's because the mark is still set at the beginning of the second paragraph. To unset the mark, press Alt A again. To select the whole document, set the mark at the beginning of the document. Then Ctrl End to go all the way down. Now the full text is selected. Now suppose I want to cut the whole selected area. For that I can press Ctrl K. So this is Nano's way of cutting text. Next, if I want to paste it back, I can press Ctrl U. So when you press Ctrl K, it either cuts the selected area or the current line, where the cursor is. For instance, I want to cut the third paragraph. For that, I can just press Ctrl K without any selection, then Ctrl U to paste it wherever you want. I have pasted it back at the same location. Also, you can perform the paste operation multiple times after the cut operation. That means I can press Ctrl U again and again, and it keeps on pasting the same line. Next, let's see how you can undo the previous operation. Here, I want to undo these paste operations. So, I can press Alt U. Okay. Suppose I want to select these list items and then copy it, for which I can press Alt 6. Then paste it here, Ctrl U. So that's how you perform a copy paste. Let me undo the paste operation, Alt U. In order to redo that, press Alt E. So Alt U for undo, Alt E for redo. Adding indentation is something that you do often when editing configuration files or writing code. To add indentation to a line, place the cursor on that line, then press Alt followed by the right curly bracket. On my keyboard layout, curly brackets are typed with the Shift key, so it becomes Alt Shift right curly bracket. And to remove indentation, you can press Alt Shift followed by the left curly bracket. Below is a list on which we can practice indentation. The list displays some fruits and vegetables, but you can see that the indentation is messed up. Pineapple and apple needs to be at the same level as apple, mango and banana. So place the cursor on that line, then press Alt Shift right curly bracket. Also remember that you can place the cursor anywhere on the line. There is no need to place it exactly at the beginning. You can also select multiple lines and apply indentation in bulk. Alt Shift opening curly bracket removes the indentation. With that, I hope the idea of adding and removing indentation is clear. There is no need to manually type in space or tab characters. Next, let's discuss the search and replace feature. To open the search bar, you can press Ctrl W. Here I am going to search for the word broccoli. And there it is highlighted. You can go to the next occurrence by pressing Alt W. Here the word broccoli has only one occurrence. To search and replace, you can press Ctrl / First, enter the word to search for. You can see that the previous search word is already showing up. Anyway, we can type it again. Then enter the replacement word also. Here I am replacing broccoli with cauliflower. Then it asks whether you want to replace the current occurrence or all the occurrences. You can press either A or Y respectively. Press A and it replaces broccoli with cauliflower wherever broccoli appeared. Let's take one more example. This time let's search and replace the word U with V. The word U appears multiple times in this document. Ctrl / to open the search box. Search for the word U. Press Enter, replace with V. Here is the first occurrence and whether I want to replace it or not. I don't want to replace if the word is at the beginning of a sentence. So I can press N, which takes me to the next occurrence. This one I want to replace, so press Y. Then it goes to the next occurrence, like that. In the end, I replaced two occurrences in the whole document. Here I could have done it better by enabling the case sensitivity option in the search box. To enable or disable case sensitivity, press Alt C while the search box is opened. By the way, reject is also supported, but that we are not going to discuss now. So Alt C to enable case sensitivity. With that, I could search for the word U only if all the letters are in lowercase. To cancel the search operation in between, you can press Ctrl C. Another useful feature is the line numbering option. You can enable or disable line numbering by pressing Alt N. It can be quite useful if you are editing code. To count the number of lines, words and characters, you can press Alt D. This document has 48 lines, 226 words and 1418 characters. To get the current scroll position in percentage, press Ctrl C. It says currently we are at line 40 out of 49, which means 81%. The numbers get updated as you move the cursor across the document. Okay, now it's time to save the changes, so press Ctrl O. Press Enter and 48 lines were updated. So far we were discussing about the Nano way of copying and pasting text. It works only within the Nano editor. However, if you want to copy paste from the editor and then paste it somewhere else outside the Nano editor, it will not work because it's not copying into the clipboard. So if I try to paste it somewhere outside, like in the Ubuntu text editor, it's not going to work. So in such cases, you can go the regular way by using the mouse to select the text. Then you can either right-click and copy or press Ctrl-Shift-C. Now the selected text is copied into the clipboard. Now I can paste it anywhere by pressing Ctrl-V. Similarly, if you want to paste some text from outside the editor into the Nano editor, you can copy it as usual, Control C, then come to the editor, then right click, then click paste or press Control Shift V. Nano also supports some basic syntax highlighting, like for this block of code here. Let's take a look at an HTML file, sample.html, nano sample.html, which opens the HTML file. You can notice that the syntax is color highlighted. The tags are somewhat bluish green in color. By default, Nano supports syntax color highlighting for certain types of files, including HTML, PHP, and Python. And these color highlighting rules are defined within the user share Nano directory. And here is the file responsible for HTML syntax highlighting, html.nanorc. Likewise, there are other files also, including Python, SQL, PHP, etc. Let's take a look at the html.nanorc file. Sudo nano html.nanorc, which opens the nanorc file in the nano editor itself. Here is the color definition for tags. Color is set to cyan. However, I don't know why the tone was a little bit different in the editor. Anyways, suppose I want to change the color to something else. For that, I can replace cyan with the desired color. So delete cyan. By the way, if you want to delete text in the nano editor, you can use delete or backspace keys. I am replacing it with yellow. Okay, save the file and exit. Now if I open the sample.html file again, you can see that the tag color has changed. Again, I don't know why I had set the tag color to yellow, but here it looks like an orange color. Maybe that's the way the terminal emulator program is mapping colors. Anyways, you can edit existing nanorc files or create new ones to add support for more languages. With that, I hope you got a basic understanding on how to use the Nano editor. I hope you learned something new today. Thanks for watching.